industry will have to have a lot of risk appetite. It's a long journey. So you have to be committed with enough risk appetite and also funds. And if you look worldwide, you will see in the Western world, a lot of the technology got built with strong support from their governments. This is a fundamental. You can talk to overseas players and they'll explain you how the technology actually got built. Now, there's some very good news here in my view. And the good news is that I remember about 8-10 years back, very specific conversation. This is not to make fun, but to make a point. Sitting with senior secretary level folks in MOD from CIA, they would just assume if somebody was giving us build to print, all technology was with us. What technology are you talking about? The understanding that you need to have your own ITR. You need to have the know why, not just know how to put screws together and how to bolt things. The culture was that once somebody is giving us a license to manufacture, we've got all the technology. I can tell you this is absolutely changed. And an evidence of that came with the discussions we had for DPP 2016. You can see a very, quite an interesting change. In my view, it's a very fundamental change. The DPP is encouraging indigenization from many different points of view. They are talking about that we need to build our own IPR. They are talking about we need to have indigenous content by value and defining value. And they are talking about categories like IDDM and giving them very high preference. Behind that, they are talking about make category that we heard about. And of course, they talked about TDF, Technology Development Fund. Now, behind that is the real thinking. Some folks in MOD finally understood that a big focus and thrust has to be given to building our own technology. Our folks must focus on building technology, which we knew was a long journey, but has to be done, and government has to come forward and support this effort. This is the change that's happened. Now, good news is that if we quickly talk about what has happened in the last few years, I'll just take quickly TDF. If you see TDF, it's been now more than a year, year and a half since DRDO is now the administrative agency, we'll say, is the nodal agency for managing it. Projects have been approved, funding has been received by industry, and the projects are rolling. And not only that, that's a start. Normally, you know, when the first project goes through, it takes long, all kinds of difficulties are there. But it's gone through the system. But with that, many more projects are starting to come in the pipeline. They are doing it in bunches, but clearly that is starting to happen. So more areas, services are identifying, and there is now a proper structure there. And this structure is supported from outside by experts. This is not totally all DRDO doing it, but they've located all the right bodies that have been dealing with technology and brought them in to help them simplify and try and make the system to move. Because there's the issue of selecting a development agency, which you can see sometimes can become very complex, but they're doing it and they've done a good job. They put a process in place which is quite transparent. So a very good foundation has been laid. And that to me is something we must be aware of and admire. But there is an issue. This is just a drop in the ocean. We need to do much more of this. Good news is